In 2257, construction of Babylon 5 was completed, and the station went online. The Vorlon ambassador, Kosh, was assassinated, and Commander Sinclair was blamed for his death. In return, the Vorlon Empire sent a fleet to Babylon 5. Commander Sinclair was killed trying to uncover the true assassin. Thinking the humans were responsible for the death of the Vorlon ambassador, the Vorlons attacked. Babylon 5 had been destroyed. The future was about to change. The year is now 2260, and Earth has become more and more distant from the other alien races. Many changes occurred within the universe. The Centauri had practically wiped out the Narn. The League of Non-Aligned Worlds was no more, and each member race took their own path. The Vorlons and the Minbari went into exile and ceased all contact with all other races. The once business-minded Brakiri had, over the years, invested more time and money into their military. After the loss of one of their transports to an Earth Force cruiser, the Brakiri ceased all future communications with Earth. My name is Frank Trigoni. I've served in Earth Force for nearly 7 years now. After spending my 2 weeks R&R in the Rocky Mountains back on Earth, here I am just entering the Vartis system, a billion miles away. My CO, Captain Sheldon, was assigned to investigate a loss of communications with the Hemingway outpost. It's now been nearly 12 days since Earth Dome lost contact. As we jumped into the Vartis system, we found out why. The outpost was now nothing but debris drifting through space. My wingmates were thinking the same thing as I was. Was this an accident, or had the outpost been destroyed? There were no other ships in the area, so a few maintenance bots were used to retrieve carbon samples from the debris to try and determine whether it was fired upon and by what sort of race and weapon. As the maintenance bots gathered their samples and headed back to the Agamemnon, we had a ping on our long-range sensors. A number of Brakiri ships had just come into the edge of sensor range and were moving in our direction. We were not sure if the Brakiri were responsible, so Captain Sheldon tried hailing the Brakiri fleet. The Brakiri did not respond. After numerous attempts to contact them, the Brakiri fleet continued to advance on our position.
Information with the fleet. EA fleet to Brakiri fleet. Please respond.
I'm picking up some sort of local. Jump points opening!
That's why they didn't fire first. They were waiting for reinforcements.
EA fleet to Brakiri fleet. Do you read?
No response.
No response, sir.
All fighters, heat them up.
They are still on an intercept course.
I don't like this.
They are opening gun ports. Repeat, they are opening gun ports.
All right, people, maintain approach and stay in formation.
Stay in formation.
Affirmative.
Energy spike.
Our ships are under attack.
This is Fleet Command. Engage Brakiri forces.
I copy. Attacking hostiles now.
Okay, right, sir.
Sensors off.
Shot, kid. Don't get caught.
lost the entire fleet.
All remaining ships, head for the jump gate. Get out of here.
Attack vector.
Oh.
Epsilon Wing here, cocked, locked, and ready to rock.
Break in attack! Come get some!
my copy.
Oh God! Help me! No! No!
That's all of them, sir.
Well done, pilots.
After the confrontation near the Varta system, we are now at war with the Brakiri. We did not expect their military strength to be a match for our fleet. We took heavy losses at the Varta system and fell back to the Earth-controlled Kepteia system. After losing many ships in our first confrontation, we retreated with only the few ships that were left. As we arrived at the Kepteia system, news of our defeat was widespread.
Captain Maya to the EA fleet. What happened out there? What's your status?
We were ordered to investigate a comms loss with the Hemingway 8 outpost. As we jumped into the system,